students in New York. And he says we should do it 300 times every day. So there's a few things to pay attention to when you're 300 rounds a day or less. Starting with your positioning. You want your feet a comfortable distance apart, what we call shoulder width. But make sure that you can just drop right into the ground through the bubbling well, keeping the three points of the tripod on each foot in equal contact. The heel, ball behind the big toe, ball behind the little toe. So that's where your feet go. Your head is as if you're hanging down. That gives you this feeling of spaciousness all through the body. So everything is nice and open. And the turning happens from the center. Shoulders stay with your hips. Nose stays with your belly button. And you just turn from side to side, keeping the feeling of openness through the body and groundedness through the bubbling wells. Weight shift will happen as you do the movement. It's not something you do. So, for example, if I do this and then turn, and then this and then turn, I'm shifting the weight as a separate event. I want to be in the center of my stance and figure out how to use my two hip joints differently. So I'm going to make the whole turn to the right off my right leg. As I do that, I'm releasing the left leg so that it doesn't get pulled with me. Once I get to the extent of my turn on my right leg, in my mind, underground, I connect with the left foot, and then I make the entire turn off the engagement of the left quad or hip joint and the conscious releasing of the right. So the movement is smooth and keeps you in the center of the stance. Oh, sure, I move a little bit, but I'm mostly staying right in the center where I can focus on the engaging of one hip joint and the releasing of the other. And then in an instant, I change, even as it takes time for that to play out in my body. So that's the mechanics at the hip joint level. What you want to do is let the whole body be free. So the arms have articulation. I'm not just keeping my arms from moving, and I'm not just moving my arms. I'm actually keeping the shoulders with the hips, turning the hips and letting go through the shoulder socket, through the arm, through the elbow, out to the palm of the opposite hand. And as I turn toward this leg, it draws a connection through the palm of the opposite hand. So this is a version of cross balance. You feel a connection from the foot to the opposite hand. The hand swings out and falls toward the body. You can kind of get this going like a perpetual motion machine. As one is falling back in, you're turning and sending the other one out. The air kind of goes through your fingers as if you were doing this in a pool. You feel the air through your hand with the palm, and you feel the ground through your foot with the tripod at the bottom of each foot. Now notice what's happening in the legs. As I turn, one leg is stable. That's this one. I'm making all the motion happen off this leg. This one, the knee is actually moving forward, following the line of the toes and releasing from the pelvis so that it doesn't get pulled with me. So an example of pulling it with me, now I'm not letting it go. And you see how it's getting pulled to the side. I don't have as good a connection. connection through the outer edge of my foot, and I haven't really let this go, even if I can pick it up. So what I need to do is really let go, let everything go. This side, in Maggie's terminology, one leg owns the pelvis. So I'm going to own the pelvis with this leg and keep freeing this one. Remember that the butt cheek around back is part of freeing that leg. It doesn't only happen in front. The whole thing has to let go, and that will send the knee passively forward. And then you change, and this one becomes stable, and now this one will have just a slight give toward the front. I want to make sure my knees have enough bend that there's some resilience, but I'm not doing this in some deep knee bend place. Let yourself be in a comfortable place and just engage one and free the other. Change in an instant in your mind at the bottom of your foot, and let that play out through the body, continually releasing the other side. And over and over, as you do this, you can be paying attention to all these different parts. Just pick one at a time. Don't spend a lot of time micromanaging it. Just give yourself a feeling and then work with it. Well, of course, I never count how many times we do this, but let's just do it a couple more times all together. Arm moves freely, waist is turning. Hips are changing, knees are resilient, feet are connected to the ground, and you're suspended from above, so the head is resting on top of the spine, and everything has room and freedom inside. You can pay attention to your breath, too. Let it just be natural. But notice if you're holding your breath. Let it just keep following your movements. Breathe from down the dantian. Let it fill the whole body. Nice and easy. There's nowhere to go. You don't have to go to the furthest extreme you possibly can. Just keep it easy, comfortable. And working all the joints in the proper time. So, here's a bit